in Mount Joy Jail. One Monday morning, high upon the gallows tree, Kevin Barry gave his young life for the cause of liberty. But a land of 18 summers, yet no one can deny, as he walked to death that morning, he proudly held his head on high. Why not shoot me? Just like a soldier. And do not hang me like a dog. For I fought to free old Ireland on that bright September morn. All around that little bakery where we fought them hand to hand. Why not shoot me just like a soldier? For I fought to free Ireland. Just before he faced the hangman in his dreary prison cell, British soldiers tortured Barry just because he would not tell the names of his companions and other things they wished to know. Turn informer or we'll kill you. Kevin Barry answered no. Standing to attention as he bade his last farewell to his broken-hearted mother, who sad grief no one can tell. That parting had to be. Then to death walks softly smiling that old Ireland might be free. Another lads like Barry are no cowards. From the fall they will not fly. Lads like
to Dublin in the green, where the helmets glisten in the sun, where the vein is flash and the rifles crash to the echo of the Thompson gun.
I'll leave behind my pick and spade, I'll leave behind my plow, I'll leave behind my old grey mare, but I'll never need her now. I'll take my short revolver and me bandolier of lead. I'll live or die, I can but try to revenge my countrymen.
And we're all up to Dublin in the green, where the helmets glisten in the sun, where the pain is flashed and the rifles crash to the echo of the Thompson gun. We're all up to Dublin in the green, where the helmets glisten in the sun, where the pain is lashed and the rifles crash through the echo of the Thompson gun. And we're all up to Dublin in the green, where the helmets glisten in the sun, where the pain is lashed and the rifles crash through the echo of the Thompson gun.
Story, the memory of Pearson McBride, whose names are illumined in glory and martyrs so long since have died. Forget not the boy of Kilmichael, those brave lads so gallant and true, who fought 'neath the green flag of Ireland and conquered the red, white and blue. Then here's to the boys of Kilmichael, who feared not the might of the foe. The day that they marched into battle, they laid all the black and tan low. On the 28th day of November, the Tans left the town of Mulroom. They were seated in two crossly tender, which led them right into their doom. We're on the road to Kilmichael, and never expected to stop. They there met the voice from the column, who made a clean sweep of them all. Forget not the boys of Kilmichael, those brave lads so gallant and true, fought in the green flag of Ireland and conquered the red, white and blue. The sun in the west it was sinking, 'twas the eve of a cold winter's day, when the Tans we were eagerly waiting sailed into the spot where we lay. And over the hill went the echo, the peal of the rifle and gun, and the flames from the larvae gave tidings that the voice from the column had won. Forget not the boys of Kilmichael, those brave lads so gallant and true, who fought 'neath the green flag of Ireland and conquered the red, white and twilight, and high over Dunmanway town. Our banners in triumph were waving to show that the Tans had gone down. So we gathered our rifles and bayonets and soon left the glen so obscure. And we never drew rein till we halted at a faraway camp of Glenure. Forget not the boys of Kilmichael, those brave lads so gallant and true, who fought in the green flag of Erin and conquered the red, white, and blue. Forget not the boys of Kilmichael, those brave lads so gallant and true, who fought in the green flag of Erin and conquered the red, white, and blue.
That sea should roll between all Ireland and her faithful sons who love to wear the green.
Oh, the wearing of the green, oh, the wearing of the green. My native land, I cannot stand for the wearing of the green.
I care not for the thistle, and I care not for the rose, while green winds round us whistle, neither down our crimson shows. But like a home that's friendless, where no joy around is seen, our great with love that's in this bloom.
Oh, the wearing of the green, oh, the wearing of the green. My native land, I cannot stand for the wearing of the green. Oh, the wearing of the green, oh, the wearing of the green. My native land, I cannot stand for the wearing of the green.
As I rolled out one day, the holy month of June, I strayed into an old churchyard to view a new-built tomb. I overheard an old man say, and a tear fell from his eyes, it's underneath that coffin sad with Peter Crowley lies. Then tell Peter Crowley, come tell me true. You stepped into Kilcudi Wood that day along with you. Who stood behind that broad oak tree and fired that signal gun? Who fought and died for Ireland's rights? Was you, my darling son? The man who fired the signal gun went to his lone abode. For many a mile he shouldered in a dark and dreary road. Stiff and cold it's there you lay, and stood in Galmacree, because you were and finish. As I have no more to say, may the Almighty and Eternal God soon raise you from your clay. With 1,000 men at your command, and they both loyal and true, to conquer English, Dutch, and Dane, as Irishmen could do. Conquer English, Dutch, and Dane, as Irishmen could do.
It was down in the town of Old Bantry, where most of the fighting was there where a young Irish soldier was shot by a black and tan gun. As he raised himself up on his elbow, as the blood
Sharon, green, white, and blue. shot in Dublin, fighting for his country bold. He fought for Ireland, Ireland only. The harp and shamrock, green, white and gold. The next time he met was a fair young maiden, kneeling low by a lover's side, praying to God, her heavenly Father, praying to God, his soul to guide. My only son was shot in Dublin, fighting for his country bold. He fought for Ireland, Ireland only. The harp and shamrock, green, white and gold. Last time in, was he dying? God bless the cause for which I died. My only son was shot in Dublin, fighting for his country bold. He fought for Ireland, Ireland.
Sun was setting o'er the bright May meadows of Chevaliers. A rebel hand set the heather blazing and brought the neighbors from far and near. Then from old Kilcarmack spurred up the rocks with a warning cry. Arm, arm, he cried, I have come to lead you for Ireland's freedom. We live or die. On against the coming soldiers, the cowardly yeomen we put to flight. 'Twas at the Harrow the boys of Wexford showed Mookie's regiment how men could fight. Look out for hurlings, King George of England. Search every kingdom where breeds a slave. For Father Murphy from the county Wexford sweeps o'er the land like a mighty wave. At Vinegar Hill, by the pleasant Slaney, our heroes vainly
burned his body upon the rack. God grant you glory, brave Father Murphy, and open heaven to all your men for the cause that called you. May come tomorrow in another fight for the green again, for the cause that called you. May come tomorrow in another fight for the green again.
About the hemp rope on his neck, the gold.
white horse right in hand. Behind him marched in grim array a surely perilous band. For Antrim town, he led them to the fray. And Roddy Foley goes to die on the bridge of June today. The gray the sash of green were brave and stainless then. A banner flashed beneath the sun over marching men. The coat had many a rent this noon. The sash is torn away, and Roddy Foley goes to die on the bridge. Then he found the foeman's heart. Through furious fight and heavy odds, he took a true man's part. And many a red coat bit the dust before his keen pike lay. But Roddy Foley goes to die on the bridge of June. Because he loved his motherland, because he loved the green, he goes to